four, five. There, I just counted to five, and on five I got it back on. Alright, just about to the top of the trees over there. That's east, northeast. Okay, because if I stand on my front porch looking directly across, I see to the right where the trees end, and you can see the road, but it's barely in the dark here. I can see it with my naked eye. That's east. That's east northeast where the moon is right now. Alrighty, come on now. It's almost over the trees. I don't know if that's condensation or not. I'm going to wipe over it, so if it goes out of focus, I'll just focus again. I'm wiping it with my shirt sleeve because I don't usually bring a tissue or anything like that out here for a lens. Sometimes if you zoom out, it'll focus, and then you can zoom in and get the craters and everything on the moon. Hey, you see the trees? It's going right over the tops of the trees right there. There, see? The trees in the bottom middle there. Moon's coming up over it. I'm going to try to angle it up a little bit. There you go, like that. When the moon gets about the middle of the screen, I'll let that record and maybe zoom in a little bit on it. See if anybody can't tell if that's a hologram or not. If you shine a flashlight at night, you'll see white particles all over the place. It almost looks like a sleet. So you think about that. That's at nighttime. You can see the particles as they fly around. So if you can see that at nighttime with a flashlight beam, a high beam, so you can see them going through there, those particles. That happens throughout the day. Every single day. All the time. So when you're out there and you're moving around, you don't think anything of it. It goes in through your eye sockets, believe it or not. The mucus of your eyes collect it. You breathe it, you open your mouth, it goes through your mouth, you ingest it, it rains into the soil, which goes into the food that you cook and you think you're getting healthy food. They're purposely doing this. Again, it sounds crazy to a lot of people, but you know what, the ones that think it's crazy, you know, I feel really, sincerely, honest to God, I'm not joking, I feel sorry for you, I really do, because there's going to be a time. And the thing is, I don't even think about my age, but now I know, I'm in my lower 50s. But before my last days, I'll probably outlive the majority of you naysayers, because you don't want to believe it. And you'll just go outside and enjoy yourselves. And, you know, I mean, I can't say you can't stop living and worry about everything, but to keep denying it just makes yourself out to be kind of a fool. You know, so I don't keep myself from doing anything, but there's really nothing for me to do. I just do my garden in the summertime. That keeps me busy. But henceforth, I will always wear a mask when I'm outside now. Even if I go to the store, I'm going to have a mask on, because I'm not going to succumb to their asshole poisons. That's pretty, though, isn't it? That's pretty. Let me see the time on here. It could be almost 6:25 right now, p.m. This is January 5th, 2015. Alright, and yeah, the moon is so bright. It's shining back on this house here. It looks like a light. But it's just that moon right there. That's how bright it is. Clear sky. I might come out here later on with the camera. I'll get the moon too, I'm sure, but to see if I see anything in the sky, because for a lot of the people out there that don't realize it, man, we've seen some weird stuff out here. I'm not lying to you. There's a video on Ozzyman 1203, and you won't be able to see it because I couldn't hold the camera still worth of anything. I swear to you, just as soon as that moon is sitting there in the sky, there was a plane off to the left of the porch here on the northern sky, dead still in the sky. Dead still. My wife kept yelling, and I come out there, and I thought she was crazy. I saw it with my own eyes. I grabbed the camera, came out here, and I could not hold the camera. I didn't have it on the tripod like I told her I should have if I could find it. I don't even know where the tripod was at that time. But the plane was dead still in the sky. It stood there. And then it just started going east. I mean, west. It was facing west in the northern sky off the porch here, facing west. And it slowly started going, and then it just picked up speed, and it went. It didn't take off like in a movie, but it just started picking up speed, and it flew off into the western sky. So my wife has actually seen the black triangles that they do have in the sky, and she's not BSing, and she's not trying to screw, you know, just make up something. I mean, she actually says she saw it, and I believe her, because I've seen things out here where I'm not sure what it is. I mean, they look like they'd be planes, but in today's age, there's no such thing as a normal night anymore. I mean, they're systematically trying to poison everybody on the planet. I saw a chemtrail out in the sky going south, southwest earlier, about maybe a half hour ago, when I was looking over to the side of the house in the yard, in the north side of the house. And it was spraying. I could see a faint line. So that means it'll be cloudy here in another day. Tomorrow afternoon it'll be overcast clouds. Okay, it's got to be about 6:28 now. So I'm going to stop this now and put in YouTube Ozzyman 1203. And then I'll put in T-Ozzy Cernic Facebook. Kind of looks like the Death Star in that Star Wars movie. Focus. Focus. It won't focus. That's the moon. That's the surface of the moon. It's a cheap ass camera. $239. Need one for around $800. Alright. First full moon of 2015. January 5th, 2015. Everybody stay safe. Heed my words, because I'm telling you, if you'll at least just take the time to look it up yourself. My wife has, and she's blowing her away. This stuff is real. Please, please, keep your family safe, keep yourself safe.